All right, game one in a brand new best of five underway for the loser's bracket. This match will sadly kick somebody out of the tournament here in the round of 16 for the Ting Open Season 2. Make sure to check out our sponsors over on bttv.ting.com because without them, this tournament would not be happening, guys. $5,000 in prizes for the players, and they're actually paying us on the side too, which is nice. We don't normally get paid to do casting, so feels hashtag feels good, man. Anyways, in the bottom left side, he's going to be the Red Terran player. Team Elevate's Red Masa.
In the top right is the Blue Terran. He's Roots Kelazor.
Okay, so while that last game for Kelazor was not so hot, as mentioned before, I really do hold him and Masa a lot closer in regards to TVT skill. I think for us, a lot of us knew Neeb was probably going to be the better person and the better player in that first game. But TVT-wise, first off, we've been seeing TVT go kind of nuts and all over the place. You know, a little bit of harassment here, a little bit of harassment there, and some games even ending around that like Hellion Reaper attack at the start. But Masa and Kelazor have shown us a good number of games in the past. Kelazor is actually, I think, some of the most notable things we've seen him do is dethrone Pulse, not once, but twice, for some of those IEM qualifiers and such. Masa, I think, has more... I'm speaking off the top of my head. I don't actually know for certain. I think Masa has more overall tournament wins than Kelazor, but Kelazor's had, like, better TBT wins than I can think of, at least.
That's an interesting way to put it. Quickly checked their stats against each other, and for the most part, Masa won, except the most recent time he did lose to Kelazor in the IEM season. 11 Shanghai tournament. So that was, like, a month ago. Yeah, Kelazor 2-0'd. So maybe feeling good about that. Of course, they probably played each other a lot more on ladder past that, so I don't think that's like, yeah, last time I beat him, it was easy. Probably lost a few times too, but I mean, you give it these names to me and you say which one, I would say Masa from like just gut reaction, but considering, I guess, Kelazor and his recent, you know, just getting better and better every single time I see him, and yeah, his TVT record against notable players, I might actually give it to Kelazor.
You know, I actually just thinking on it, my reasoning earlier at the start of the cast was I'm cheering for Kelazor because he played Overwatch with me the other night. It's now occurring to me maybe I shouldn't be cheering for him because he was playing Overwatch with me the other night instead of StarCraft. this is really greedy from Masa, by the way. A third CC is not at all uncommon, but a third CC on location this early is. And this Reaper fight starts off terribly for Kelazor. He does get a grenade to try and redeem himself a bit, but this is... He actually can't fight right now.
I feel like this is something that you can do if you have those double Reaper openers. Like, it's so much scouting, and hopefully against someone who's not going for a one base build, which Masa knew, it's not too dangerous either. Like, I'm going to lose them very quickly. So while he ends up losing his Reapers, and that sucks, no more time bot, no more scouting, although he's kind of natural now, he sees enough to know that his third CC is going to finish. It'll probably get some SCVs on it, and of course, later on, when push comes to shove from Kelazor, ideally he'll have some scouting with a Marine or something.
Yes.
To know to lift it in time.
That's the thing for Kelazor, because the Reapers got stuck at home. He didn't actually scout this third CC on location.
Oh, and that sucks for Kelazor.
We've talked a lot about the dynamic of two bases versus three bases, but that's usually because you're planning on two bases while they're planning on three. This is something where he's a little bit caught off guard by it, so...
Oh, come on, no. He might... I don't know. Lack of production, but
I don't think he saw enough to cause red flags.
I don't think so either.
By the way, we got a couple of resubs we missed out on. Once again, sorry guys. Stream delay, commercial breaks, all that good stuff. Thank you to TCampbell88, to Gerthang3019, and just now, moving laterally, all of you hitting us up with over 15 months of resubs. Thank you so much for continuing to support the channel and for doing it for so damn long. Moving laterally, of course, hashtags butts in his resub message.
Makes sense. Kelazor, unfortunately, not with all the scouting he would really need to have to have confidence in this game. If he has confidence, well, then it's wrong.
Oh, okay. That's not where I thought that was going.
Exactly. But the good news is that I think Kelazor is going to push regardless if it was a two-base or a three-base. That might not be true. I mean, he might be expecting like a two-base drop, for instance, and that would really suck in that case because he's just keeping his units at home and they're not doing anything. But if he does push, he'd see like, oh, there's a third base. It's a good thing that I did some harassment, and then he can get his own third as well, which of course it'll be very, very late, but at least he can have the knowledge to choose third base or, you know, continued all in. These streamers are look very nerd. You look very nerd. Han DeVis. Yeah, I called you out.
I mean, is there something wrong with looking like a nerd?
There's something wrong with improper grammar.
That's true, but I just feel like that should be the issue we're addressing, not the immediate
response. You're improper grammar.
Okay, yep. Yeah. You know what? It came down to grammar, guys. My bad.
I don't think I look like a nerd. I think I'm a stereotypical nerd. I don't think that you look like a nerd right now, and I haven't even seen you today. Well, you do wear glasses. I guess that's pretty stereotypical.
Well, I was on the verge of saying thank you, but I'm glad I didn't.
Well, you said something wrong with looking like a nerd anyway, so...
Yeah, but you quickly went from, you're fine, but maybe you're not.
I didn't say fine. Oh, he dives in with... Stereotypically nerd.
I don't know about diving with the tanks like that. Now they're stuck behind enemy lines. And granted, Masa can't exactly walk up and clean them up, but there's no way to really support these.
That does suck. Masa...
Kelzer's got stim. He's going to rush in, but that wasn't both tanks picked up. That was only one. The bunker's going to break, and that will give him the ability to save his tank as he collapses on the other. This might just end up working for him. As weird and stupid as that tank drop was, SCVs are pulled into it. The tank goes down, but he shuts down this third. Now,
the medevac, bring it forward.
The thing about this, though, that's so underwhelming, doesn't kill the third. And the fact that he drives us off merely, if anything, evens up the game. But even then, he's still behind.
Yeah, he took a bit of an army supply lead. But
it's like for a brief moment, you're like, oh, that was freaking awesome. And then you're like, oh, that was totally adequate.
That perfectly sums it up. But
this is actually what it is. It's you moments ago. This exact same thing. We're like, oh, it's fine. It's not.
Whatever.
You look okay. Yeah, you're kind of a nerd.
I'm actually having trouble thinking of the last time I've seen someone where I was just like, I looked at him and I was like, oh, that's a nerd. I've looked at someone and said, oh, she probably likes comic books. Or, oh, he probably plays video games. Because, like, they're wearing a t-shirt or something, right? But I don't think I've ever looked at someone and been, like, dork or nerd. Not, like, a serious fashion.
I mean...
Isn't that so 80s?
Fairy dragon?
What? Did you say to me?
I was just saying, Fear Dragon's a little bit nerdy. Not in a bad way, but he's like that adorable He's adorable little dork. I don't know.
He wears like nice clothing. You know, like got that Banana Republic thing I had to send to him.
Banana hammock.
Was it Banana Republic? It was something. Something fancy.
Alright, well, shots needlessly fired at Fear Dragon.
Yeah, right? Who's shooting these now?
This drop's going to go towards the main. Mas is actually pretty badly out of position for this. He will respond with his own drops, and those Vikings going to shoot out the medevacs. This might not go so well for Kel'Azur. The opportunity looked prime, and I understand dropping, but this ended up going so badly for him.
You're never truly out of position when you have tank drops.
Well, I think it's for me a lot less about the tanks and a lot more about the Vikings.
The Vikings really helped, but I think that like you see an opportunity like that, and you're like, oh, this is the best opportunity. You kind of forget that, one, your tank fire shots, even though they come down first, might go on something useless, like a reactor or something. So that'll suck. And then your Marines aren't dropping as quickly, so you don't have much cover anyway. The point is, Masa was just a little bit too close, so while it did look out of position, I don't think it really was. It was slightly 5 degrees off position. And Kel'Azur, I'm guessing he regrets it, but look at the numbers, and it's very even.
Well, speaking of numbers, it's kind of important what you just said. Is that 5 degrees Fahrenheit or 5 degrees Celsius?
It's an angle, nerd.
Angles are from heaven.
You don't measure that. Also, were you so proud of me that I gave you Celsius yesterday? You're welcome.
I mean, you're like...
Enjoy your not freedom.
You ballparked it. Yeah, I don't think you like looked it up.
No, I did. I went to Google.
Oh, and I am impressed. I'm retroactively impressed.
It was like 32.33 Celsius, something like that.
See, for me, I don't know Fahrenheit. I'd be like, it's 30 Celsius today, so I don't know, like 500 Fahrenheit, because that sounds about right. Like,
it's 95 degrees, or 90, I figure which one. It was hot. And it's still... I'm so mad, right? As we have a little bit of stalemate right here. I've been checking California weather as well to see, like, what should I bring? It is a pleasant 75 breezy in California. In Virginia, it's 95 and death will come.
It's been raining here the last week, so I have no real comment on this. Kind of sucks. I've been trying to go for walks with the umbrella. It's just not the same. All right.
Oh, well.
These tanks are quite numerous, but for Moss and Kel'Azur, so much of this really does come down to who gets their tanks on the grounds first. I mean, I think... for a long time. We still, to an extent, have people who are upset with the tank drops. They don't really understand how they work. The dynamic is left with question marks and sometimes looks a little unfair. But the core premise really is, did you land your tanks first? Did you get the first shot off? Congratulations, you've tank dropped successfully.
Usually. There's a bit more finesse to it, but yeah. That is the general gist of things. Because, okay, that's a freebie from Asa. That is really nice from Asa. And even this... I thought he might get on the tanks.
No, Masa's got better upgrades coming to this too, so the Marines are just going to demolish no matter what. That 2-2 is actually a big deal over 2-1. In other matchups, it's not as, I think, critical, but in TVT, it really, really is. And this base gets shut down. No cancel. It's a kill. Kelzer now in a bit of trouble. Oh. He had a couple of powerful moments in this game, but I'm curious how much of this boils down to Masa's faster third, like that he took very early on. Got away with for so long, too.
I think that definitely played a big part into it. You know, it's a bit of a faster upgrade. Any point he had maybe like the slightest army supply lead. He definitely was winning the economic war for a very long time, but it came down more to the army engagements.
Yeah,
bad drop into the lack of defense there.
GG does get called, and Masa will take game number one. Folks are asking who won with Kneeb and Kelazur. Well, this is the loser's match, so if you can't figure it out from that statement, then I wish you the best of luck in life, because you'll need it. Silliness aside, this is the loser's match currently. The winner's match of Hydra versus Kneeb will be coming up afterwards. I think, as you said before, if there's one person to dethrone Hydra, it would be Kneeb and vice versa, so that'll be a good set.
Yeah. I think you played the Dusk Tower intro before I could show seafood to the stream.
Oh, did you do something gross?
Yeah, seafood.
See, I was also rubbing my eye at the same time, thus my glasses were off, like they are right now, so...
I was really hoping stream would have seen it.
She does this thing, guys. She thinks she's so clever. Like, I don't understand what it is.
Everyone laughs, okay? They might
no,
facepalm first.
Everyone laughs.
Everyone starts to giggle.
No. Here's what happens, okay? Because I think you're severely misunderstanding the situation. You will do this gross thing where you show the food, specifically to me. I will be like, ugh, no thank you. And then you'll do it again, and my grossed out reaction is what makes people laugh, okay?
No, I've done it to people without you there. And then they facepalm and then they giggle because I'm stupid. But that's what any joke is, just someone being stupid.
Yeah, true enough. All right, well, we find ourselves getting into King Sejong Station, game number two in this best of five. Spawning here in the upper left side of the map. He's currently down one game, but it was a pretty good game regardless. It's going to be the Red Terran player, Root Gaming's Kelazur.
In the bottom right is the Blue Terran. He is Masa.
All right, so Masa. That third CC was certainly cheeky, and I don't think it's something we're going to see even more than one time in the series, at least on location like that. A third CC is not that crazy. We see it all the time in the naturals of Dust Towers. You know, they just bulk it up there and transfer it over later, but that economic lead was crazy, and we saw even then disadvantaged how close Kelazur almost brought that game to being a good fight for him. So I think if this is a little more even footing, King Sejong's a really great Marine tank map, and it classically has been since its inception, like 2 years ago. So it's something where I think both of them are going to play fairly comfortable on, as nobody, at least of these two, really plays anything different. You know, we saw Beastie bring out Mech and surprise us, but no one else really.
Yeah, Beastie cutie, man. I wish he would get farther in front of his
opponents. Yeah, I don't know what it is that shuts him down, because Beastie's got really creative builds, he's got smart tactics, but he just always... He'll lose at semifinals or quarterfinals, and I would love to see him do really well.
Yeah, but unfortunately he is just, for now, an online tournament weekly champion. That's who you can call him, but maybe eventually he'll come back as that tournament winner. We have a one-base build getting set up for Masa, so the complete opposite of last game. Kelzer will be able to scout this and is fine putting his command center on location. Typically, they won't hit before the command center is done, so it's still a safe move to do. But he might have to lift that natural.
I'm having a five-year-old moment. Is desert spelled with two S's or one?
What type of desert?
Well,
apple pie or cherry?
See, that's my point here.
The desert is spelled with one S. Dessert is two S's.
What about Desro?
One S.
Okay.
Not capital, I think.
Okay. Well,
wasn't he one of those guys that was a little like, you know,
yeah,
everyone
super
had like,
anal
like
about the R in his name.
Yeah, there was a couple of people on Twitter.
The SCV wanted to get that kill, that would have been nice, but Masa's SCV is shut down and pushed off. The barracks to the side is a little bit cheeky, but I guess it's funny because we see the depots over here as well. These are just like anti-reaper placements more than anything else. Mm. Other maps, yeah. You see somebody build like this, you start suspiciously going, okay, where's the second and third racks coming down? Like, it's
right, yeah.
Just King Sejong being good old King Sejong.
Yeah, exactly. Nothing to see here. We do, I guess. Masa didn't go for a true one boost build. Was I crazy? Like, did he come in center after factory? He must have, right?
Well, yeah, that's how timing works. Otherwise, the starport would still be building, because he'd have to put the money into the other way around.
Well, I'm just confused as to why he didn't go for the full 1-1-1 into command center instead 1-1 command center 1.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess. Okay. Having scouted, initially it looked a little bit awkward. He wasn't sure, but then realized that was a normal build. Kelsir is going to be the one who actually boldly steps forward and puts his third on location this time. And I want to really emphasize something, because we talked about it quite a bit. It was not simply the act of taking a base and putting on location that won Masa that game. A lot of good decision making, good drops, good pickoffs with the Vikings. And again, going back to that Viking defense in that main, that's what won Masa the game. The third base does give him that faster economy, and maybe Kelzer can take advantage of that or not. But either way, the drop's already here. And while he doesn't know about the base, he's about to. And he should be able to at least stall it out, kill the SCV, if not kill the command center.
Yeah, this is already like 10 times better than what Kelizer had to deal with last game. I mean, Masa scouting the third on location, great, now he has more information, and then denying it a little bit and forcing Kelizer to come from the safety of his natural to defend it. I mean, this doesn't look like a lot, but this early on, this is one of the reasons you don't go for a third CC on location. But I think he might just save it. He has his own tank on the way out. That was tricky. That was very tricky. The meta was gonna go down. I'm not sure that was weird. He picked up in the medivac and then decided not to.
Nope.
And now this is weird. Okay then.
Okay, so that's a bit of a gimme. This actually puts Masa in a pretty terrible spot should Kelizer have been prepped and ready to go with an immediate counterattack, but he's not. Third CC being on location still though is going to be ahead enough that with the current army he has plus that, he is in a great spot.
Yeah. Well, It's going to come back down to engagements and how good each other are at taking them. Last game, I would say that, this seems to be Kelizer's problem in general, to say it right now. Like, why I'm a little hesitant to ever give Kelizer the win is that he has good ideas and he wants to be aggressive, you know, and it's just that there's almost a lack of control, you know? Like, his power level is 9,000, but he can't actually control it.
He can't so access Super Saiyan mode, is what you're saying, even though he is a Saiyan.
I mean, not quite, but sure. Anyway, he'll do these very aggressive maneuvers, and they'll just die. And he'll be like, "Why'd you do that?" When, you know, maybe if he saw innovation do it, it actually would work. That type of thing.
Oh.
So he does make these pretty crucial mistakes sometimes.
This is clever in chat, by the way. I like this. Dessert has two S's because you always want more.
Aww.
That is clever.
You're teaching 5-year-old. You're right.
I mean, there's some words I feel like I'm ever going to feel normal about. Like, Wednesday is always Wed NES Day.
Wednesday,
beginning is Beg-in-ing. Like,
yeah, I always forget the word that I can't spell until I can't spell it. But beginning, I know a word. Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, beginning is a word I actually had a lot of trouble with until I would say even my 20s. And when I was writing essays and stuff, it would always be like, I would just go on tilt, like, starting today. Like,
yeah. I was going to say, for whatever reason, I'm pretty specific about how I say aunt. I don't know what it is. My entire family says aunt, and I've never liked it. Ants are things that walk on the ground. They're super small, okay?
I guess it's not that big of a deal. It's like mana versus mana, like.
That also might bother me when Fear Dragon says mana. Anna.
Mana like your nana and mana like your aunt.
Aside from things that bother me, I guess, including the list of velvet and something else that I forget. Masa has not been doing a very great job this game. This is clever. I like this a lot, but he lost his first drop and he lost his second drop, which is what I was going to talk about. Thankfully, he pushes this way with a problem.
I think with the concentrated Viking fire, I don't think we would have had to disengage quite so quickly as we just saw, but one Marine gets down here and I guess killed an SCV and then blood splatter.
Yeah, bye-bye. Masa does have slightly faster upgrades. We'll see if he keeps those.
This is actually going to be really impressive to me if Masa wins this game. And not because I think Kelizer's done anything bad. I think his execution's been good. He hasn't over-dedicated. That attack really... okay, could have got much worse. But it'd just be more to showcase how good Masa is to be able to bring this back from a position where he was behind. You know, you talk about losing a couple drops. Army supplies even. Masa's got better upgrades. Kelizer should be the one leading in every which way.
Oh, okay, never mind. I thought one of them had combat shields, but both of them still don't. Kelizer hasn't started his, that might be an uh-oh.
Yeah, that's going to be huge, actually. Masa, well, it's not in effect just yet, so it's not that big of a deal right this second. Bunker's going to go down, but buys a little bit of time for the tanks to position themselves. Viking's trying to get some shots in the sky, but the tank positioning out of Masa might just be too good.
Four tanks is quite a lot. I really think Kelizer is going to be able to push this back.
He should be able to, yeah, and especially even maybe picking off those medevacs.
Yeah, he's got this. Scamancer is getting quite low, though.
Oh, if he doesn't repair or lift it, like one of the two, if not both.
This is also really good damage, you know? That's minerals not... SCV's not mining, and minerals spent on repairing the command center.
You know what? There's also round two coming up next as well, and combat shields is about to be done.
He is down 20 army supply, though. Kelizer just hasn't brought his reinforcements forward. That's why it looks closer than it is.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah,
I thought for a moment, like, there's no way he should have so little army. Like, that does not register with me at all.
Medivacs are so much supply.
Yeah.
Unlike
Tempest, am I right?
No, you. He's start shit. Masa should really take out that Zelnaga, too, by the way. That is not the best. Oh my god, this is so bold. Why would you ever? That wasn't going to work out for either one of you both in your...
I don't know what... At what point something registered said this will be a good idea.
Damn it.
So, Masa will not be making the amazing moves to bring that excellent, excellent comeback from an early game fumble, but still not out of the game yet. He's taken a fourth on location. Kelizer, I don't believe, even has a fourth CC up yet. So, given enough time, 10 minutes, fast forward from now, he very well may take a lead thanks to this.
Oh, God. Well, yeah, given enough time, Masa will recover. But had he played a little bit safer, had he not let his Marines, get AI'd into the tank fire and he didn't push like he just did, he would have a solid supply and the potential to abuse that combat shield. Now the combat shield's probably going to finish anyway, and he doesn't have supply to abuse it anyway. 30, 40 supply is quite a difference.
Yeah. People in chat bring up other words too. Absolutely agree. Necessary is a pain in the butt. License, I actually still struggle with. The S and the C, I regularly will swap.
License, yeah, that's difficult. For sure.
I think this language is total butts, man.
The rules don't say the same.
You know what's easy to spell, though? Ting.
Ting.
Shout out to Ting.
Sorry, you say okay. Ting?
Chandler Ting, yeah. Alright, this fight actually ends up going pretty nice for Masa if he had been able to pounce on those tanks, but the Marines rush in from Kelizer. He does actually have combat shields now, by the way. I guess that's worth noting because of the big deal we had made earlier, but this army for Masa gets absolutely destroyed. The Vikings will execute anything that barely escapes. The tank not even going to get out alive. It looks like King Sejong Station just got locked down by Kelizer, because even if this game was on another 20 minutes, there's like three times the army supply. Masa should not be able to recover from this position unless Kelizer makes a grave mistake. In fact, SCV's getting pulled into the fray. I mean, they're in the dead zone of the tanks.
Some of the tanks.
Splashing each other. Guys!
They did better than those tanks did for Masa.
It's still 20 warriors dead, though. And reinforcements are here for Kelizer. So, clever and cool and cute as that may have been, it's not going to be enough. The command center... not even an orbital. Doesn't even matter if it lands, but it's just a freebie.
It'll tank some shots, yeah. GG!
Alright, Kelizer will tie it up 2-2. And we're going to go to a commercial break. So don't go anywhere, guys. Just 2 minutes. I have Twitch ads, and we'll see you soon. Excuse me, you guys just heard really gross noises there because I was trying to swallow the bite of this protein bar I had during the break. And I'd unmuted myself slightly too soon. But we are back! And it is game number 3. And this is sadly my dinner. In the bottom left side of Ruins of Endion, we do have the Red Terran just tied the series up 1-1. It's going to be Root Gaming's Kel'Azur.
In the bottom right is the Blue Terran. He's Massa.
All right, and hitting it across the map pretty quick for that scout. Just occurred to me, though, because of the WCS Challenger stuff that we had been asked to cast oh so very last minute, what I mean by that is less than 24 hours before the actual event, didn't realize we'd have to wake up tomorrow at 9 a.m., so I'm going to have to actually set on my alarms for that, because didn't have anything set for that.
Yeah, remember to wake up. I can casually get up at 11 o'clock.
Actually, it was really funny, because I think it was Sky had tweeted at me asking how you wake up so early and stay up so late, and it's like 11 alarm clocks, and tweeted a picture of my phone with all my alarms, and Boris and like 5 other people replied, and like so many people, I guess, are in the same boat as me, were like, that first one just doesn't do it.
Yeah. That's my one blessing in life, is that I can tell myself when to wake up, and I do.
Hey man, yeah, I wouldn't mind. That's not a bad superpower, if we're going to be honest.
That SCV scout was just a little too early to be a scout, and then of course it didn't scout at all. It just went to the north and built a barracks.
Yeah, and okay, so this is interesting for a couple different reasons. Because one is we've actually seen people just put the second barracks out in their natural up here or anywhere else, and it's not that big of a deal. But because he's fought with Kel'Azur at the front, Kel'Azur didn't get in to see gases. So this doesn't look too odd to him, it just looks a little bit strange in the positioning, being less conventional than normal. Fakes out building a command center too. Oh, this is dirty. This is a tech lab. Is this gonna be Marauders and a Reaper? What?
This isn't the first time we've seen it. It's like the second time we've seen it.
Okay, so yeah, this is something that can work. I want to really emphasize that quickly for everyone tuning in, but the Reaper at home will defend against the one Reaper, so he's not gonna be left with nothing. Other side of the map, that Marauder will tear through depots pretty quickly. And Kel'Azur's factory and production and everything is being prioritized, so he doesn't actually have that many units coming out.
Yeah. Yeah, you never really do if you open up like this. That is quite sucky. It's quite clever for Massa, but quite sucky for Kel'Azur, who's going to have, you know, units that aren't that bad against Reapers. You know, counter grenades and Hellions. But the Marauder was slow. Is going to mix things up here.
This is so cool, though. I like this. I want to see how this plays out. Like, I am cheering for Kel'Azur still truly and entirely, but I'm rooting for Moss on this one game because I want to see this work.
Yeah. Well, these aren't the scary thing. The Marauders, they hit. There we go. Tag the Hellion, which is pretty nice.
Too slow to escape.
Oh, great. I can start harassing here, but he's gonna have to come back home with his Reapers. Obviously, Command Center is not gonna fall to 2 Marauders. The supply depot should.
Still not feeling great for Kel'Azur here as far as the defense goes. The bunker coming down is kind of a huge deal. He's going to get the reactor as well. That's expensive. That's not even just like mineral and gas expensive. That's time expensive.
Yeah, that could have been 1-2 Marines already out, but instead there's nothing, so the supply depot goes down really quickly. No repair.
I mean, he's about to get
other
supply blocked. Other side of the map, looks like these Reapers did break the defense, so if it comes down to a base trade, funny enough, I still favor Massa. Actually, Kel'Azur does get a Widow Mine down, though. This is a big, big, big aspect of it. Liberator comes out next.
Massa needs that factory to finish so he can either Widow Mine or ideally a Starport.
Kel'Azur supply block. Oh, that sucks.
Wow, scandals on this. It can't help but the Liberator, though. What's he gonna do about that back at home?
Right, there's gonna be like a single Marine. That'll take forever to kill it. SCVs could get pulled on top of Marauders. SCVs are actually really good against Marauders, for those who don't know, and you've never played this dynamic before. But as we see four of them still a lot, and they're just tearing through them slowly. This is going to come down to the wire pretty hardcore, and I guess having a second command center done is probably one of the bigger aspects of this. Massa can't actually build SCVs or drop mules. Kel'Azur can, and from two different bases. So if they both end up with no SCVs at the end of the day, Kel'Azur wins.
I think Kel'Azur is winning.
Yeah, I mean, back on the other side of the map, those Liberators, that Liberator shuts out the entire base. As stated, this wasn't finished yet, so it doesn't have anyone to mine from. Two Reapers did a lot of damage. And, of course, we're focusing a lot on the Marauders, but this ends up going so much better for Kel'Azur than it did for Massa.
Yeah, this is a very odd game, but now we know. Just imagine if Kelzer's Reapers had gone earlier.
But Liberator's going to have to play back and forth a little bit without a second one here to police both command centers. CSV's just transfer over to mine once again. But Kelzer is mining. He pulls this base back, not wanting to dick around with it, and that's not a bad reply at all. Masa's not really got any options.
Yeah. This is probably game over for Masa, but he's trying to rack his brain right now, thinking, okay, what can we bring this back? Once that Banshee shows up, I think that's going to be tap out time.
Yeah. Thank you to Sated or Satet68 for the 5-month resub. Booyah! They say in chat with that. I love that new resub message thing. I haven't gotten to use that for anybody yet, though, because I guess none of my resubs have come up since they've implemented it. But I want to see what happens if I could spam like a lot of emotes. Just put like 14 kappas in that message.
Dreams be dreams.
This barracks looks a little out of place, but he needs the high ground vision it provides.
Hey, it's Oli Moli.
Speak of the devil. Oli Moli, thank you for the 22-month resub, girl. Long time, big love. Banshee does go across the map, though, and I guess I didn't realize the Liberator had been actually cleaned up, but it's still GG. He knows it, we know it, and game number 3 is going to go in the favor of Kelzer.
Oh, shit.
Not too shabby.
Next map is going to be Frost. Frosty.
That game, by the way, is not even close to the scrappiest TVT we've ever seen, but that became really, really scrappy for both of them very quickly.
I'm surprised how quickly it snowballed for Masa, but it makes sense. Air beats Marauders.
Well, what's the map? Sorry, I'm gonna get the intro.
Frost. There's no intro.
Oh. Then we're good. Excellent. Good times. Excellent. Well done. Don't know why I'm doing a voice right now. I'm actually starting to feel a little bit hunger loopy.
Yeah, that's probably it.
What are we hotting at?
Nothing. I'm playing around with chat.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, we don't do a lot of North American broadcasts anymore, so I really don't have plans. I just grabbed a protein bar and thought it'd be good. It's not enough.
Yeah. I really want coffee, but I really don't want a coffee addiction. So that's kind of.
I would be okay if you had a coffee addiction.
No, it stains your teeth, and it's a reliance, and
your teeth
are
already
can't commit to it.
Your teeth are fucked up, anyways. Who cares?
They're not fucked up. They just got fixed.
So there you go.
Go to the dentist.
He's gonna fix again later. Easy.
No, thank you.
What if they? I guess I wonder how impractical it would be to have something that was kind of like Invisalign, but not like braces for your teeth full time, but more like, oh, I'm gonna drink some coffee. I'll just put this on, so I'm gonna stain my teeth.
Well, the problem with that is that, like, you're not supposed to, like, brush your teeth after drinking coffee or drinking soda, right?
Really? I didn't know that.
I think, maybe I'm wrong, maybe it's like a rumor and it was just something stupid, but it's supposed to be, like, since it's, like, something to do with your enamel and that you're, like, helping brush it away since the carbonation has already ruined it. Might just be for soda. I don't know.
Interesting.
Facts with Zombie Grub.
Yeah.
Sort of kind of facts.
Alright, well, game number 4, and this is kind of a big deal. Being up 2-1, now leading the series and on the verge of knocking his opponent out of the tournament. In the top left side, playing for the loser's match, it's going to be the Root Gaming player, Kelazur.
In the bottom right, Saz the Blue Terran. He elevates Masa. You ever, you know, sometimes you, like, you talk back to your cat, you know, and you're like, meow, 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 right? You don't lie to me. You've done it right.
Go on.
Have you ever, you know the other
I
sounds
I want to see where
make?
This is going.
You know the other sounds they make besides meow? They kind of go like, like they're just making sounds like from the throat.
Yeah.
Do you ever do that back to your cat? They're like, and you're like, No. I just communicated with Apollo to get him on my lap. Now he's all cute and cuddly.
Rather than agree or disagree with you, I'm much more enjoying watching you squirm under the lack of a reply. Like I know I'm a cat person, but don't judge me too hard. Because, you know, All right. By the way, Reaper does kill an SCV, so First Blood goes to kill Azur. First Blood, of course, has no bearing on the game. It's just something we do on the stream because of reasons.
Yeah.
Are you playing the drums with your mouth now?
No. One base build from Masa versus just... it's a very similar game to last game, I suppose, without the proxy.
So when it comes to cats...
Yeah?
I definitely will be like, how's it going?
Meow.
Or if they start meowing at me, I'll just meow back at them.
Why is the common response to, like, a dog or a cat when they speak to go, I know! I know. Like, so many people do that.
I know. thank you to the new sub, by the way. We got Beadrick. Beadrick! Thank you for subbing! Actually, that name's probably not Irish at all, but thank you, nonetheless, for the sub. Okay, so this attack on Amas is deadly, and I like that Kelizer's not underestimating this. He pulls everything back towards the main. He may not even be able to hold this ramp. It's questionable. Like, you might not think two Reapers and two Hellions is that big of a deal, but it really is.
Yeah, it's a lot of power, but Supply Depot certainly helps, and Kelizer going for a similar composition also helps. But now there's more to it. There's a medevac on the way, and Kelizer needs to be very careful. He needs to get shots off on the unloading army, and even then, that might not be enough.
Yeah, that's a lot more for Masa, and this actually doesn't get seen, so...
Well, is... Okay, yeah, I was gonna say, he could go for the SCVs, but the Hellions are all end up with a ramp, looks so tempting.
Advantage still goes to the medevac, I feel, though. There's not any anti-air unless the Liberator wants to sit there and take forever to shoot down an armored unit, so... Reapers will get a couple of extra heals. Hellions have been, for the most part, culled, so there's not that many left. Masa, still though, plenty of potential to kill SCVs.
Yeah, he needs to move that Liberator. There's nothing else on the way. A Viking that can land, I suppose, but...
Yeah, the SCVs are going to take solace inside the Liberation Zone range, or try to at least. Hellions just go completely around it. Awkward! Yeah,
that doesn't work. This is some serious damage. Despite Masa being up 5 workers, there's also all this lost mining time.
Okay, so he did kill the medevac, so that kind of takes some ease out on this, and the Viking lands and all that goodness. I see he's trying to surround on this side. For Kelizer, I still think the fact that he got that second command center done so quick, it's recoverable. This isn't even an orbital yet, so as far as replacing the damage he took, that's not so bad yet. Asterisk, a lot of low SCVs being pulled into Reapers. The question is, like, whether he can do anything back to him. I mean, that Liberator goes across the map, and that's a smart move, but there's going to be a Viking out. Masa won't take damage from this.
Yeah, this is some really terrible damage. Oh, the Banshee! Oh, no. Viking's still around, but Cloak is done, and just run away from the stand.
He does need some mule, but... Okay, just sits inside of it.
Oh, he's going to die because of it.
All right, other side of the map, Liberator sets up, gets about 4 kills, but taken out by the Viking pretty quickly. So, all in all, reassessing where we're at, command centers have more or less evened up. This is still not an orbital, I take that back. But still, kills are down about 10 workers. Now, I really want to emphasize this for the non-Terran players and the non-Terran fans of the audience. Being down in workers is not as big of a deal in this matchup as it is every single other matchup in the game. Like TVT, you can play on a worker deficit and still come out ahead.
Well... Masa certainly has spiked up in the income graph, and he's looking pretty good there, but yeah, the army is usually what's most important, and Masa, he still has chances to do more economic damage. I mean, another Banshee's on the way. Kelizer, not so much. He can't really harass with anything that I see here. The Cyclone tried.
Yeah.
You like harass, don't you?
No, yeah, I do.
Hey!
It depends who we're talking about. We all know I'm all about them legs and the butts. No, I was actually giggling at everyone saying I sound more Scottish than Irish. And obviously that's in prep for the new season of Samurai Jack coming out, because everyone knows Samurai Jack and the Scotsman are the best duo ever.
I don't get that.
Did you never watch Samurai Jack?
You know, I really didn't think it was very good when I first watched it.
Huh.
So, no.
I liked it quite a bit, but...
most people did. And they got canceled.
I'm excited the fact that it's not that just that they're bringing it back, that they're doing it with a theme aimed at adults is what I'm really excited about. So it won't be super silly kiddie stuff. Like, it's actually going to have some serious themes to it.
Oh. Oh, yeah?
Plus, I like Powerpuff Girls, and I thought he looked like the professor.
Well, there's that theory. I mean,
there's
I
that whole theory, too, yeah. But, like, how it's also the Powerpuff Girls town in the background, like, one of the episodes.
Man, I was reading... So, it's one of those things that's a theory, but they don't just tell you, like, here's my theory. They make a story, right?
Right.
So, they were telling a story about how, like, there is this guy who was a really evil genius type, and he had a little brother, and his little brother wanted to be a woman, basically. Like, she was transgender. But the guy really hated that and thought he was an abomination. And, like, it keeps on going and going and going. What you realize at the end is that it's the Powerpuff Girls, and Professor X is the bad brother, the evil genius, and him, that was his name, is the little brother. They got, like, you know, chased away and, you know, started the evil
devil lobster ballerina thing. Yeah.
Yeah. It was clever because it really did take you quite a time. We'd be like, oh, okay, that's cool. Anywho, Kelizer finally has something to deal damage with. You know, the Viking control was pretty important, and that's what I was going to get on before we talked about Samurai Jack. But it was, you know, it was missing anything on the ground that could actually do damage with it.
This is a bit awkward. Tanks are actually going to be in range of this still. Masa making a small mistake. Going to cost him two of his tanks so far.
Yeah. And this is how Kelizer comes back into this game.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's still down in army. He's still down in workers. And he's down in upgrades. I mean, there's so much going not in his favor. But try.
These tanks, by the way, are seriously like a pixel of difference between the two of them.
Jesus. There was a drop that was unloaded heading to Kelizer's natural, but as long as it's the natural, that's fine.
Kelizer is at a bit of a supply deficit, not just overall, but also when it comes to army. Vikings in the middle of the map, please don't die. These are probably the best. I was going to say, these are one of the best things Kelizer is going for him. So losing those would have been a little bit harsh to deal with. I guess Stim is done for Moss, but not quite done for Kelizer. Moss is going to have that nice lead on combat shields, but we saw that two games ago as well. So might not be that big of a deal.
Hmm.
It can be, though. Like, really, that 10 health, the one upgrade difference. Like, Terran, it's funny. You've got really extraordinary differences in this matchup than others. Like, ZVZ, if you're down in workers, you're pretty much screwed. TVT, who cares how many workers you have? You got mules, baby. But one level of upgrade difference? Oh, you're dead. Combat shields? You're dead.
It's a pretty big deal. Masa is really expanding on his lead. Better production coming out here. Although he is falling behind on upgrades now. But certainly better production, and these drops are going to look to do something. But I think the most important drop goes to the Vikings. Their patrol path, unfortunately, doesn't get them the best shots possible.
But this still is going to shut down medevacs, and if there's no support to heal this, this doesn't have staying power. But one medevac does barely live. Kelizer is busy dealing with drops over here, so losing his entire natural in the process. Kelizer, we're talking about getting back into the game, lost that momentum. Now it's Masa who's reigning supreme. Natural base has been lifted. That's how bad this has gotten. And now Masa, once again, just reasserts control. 84 army supply to 53.
Yeah, this is the point where it's probably just game. We'll see if Kelizer cleans this up. He cleans up this faction really, really well, but then loses the third base, so doesn't even clean it up.
All right, that's going to tie it up now 2-2. We're going to get our first ace match of the day going into game number 5 next. We are going to take a small commercial break before we get there, but I just want to really tear Zombie Grip down a little bit more before we get there. Look at her, guys. Look at this beautiful person I'm sitting next to. Not only does she not like Samurai Jack, she doesn't like Monty Python, she doesn't like Firefly. She doesn't like a lot of things that I think a lot of us will like. And does that make her a bad person? Maybe. But I'm going to say objectively no. It just makes her a different person.
Wow.
Anyways, without giving her any time to respond, we're going to go to a commercial break, and we'll see you guys in 2 minutes.